I'm James Hopkins and I'm a songwriter. I started playing piano when I was 5 years old, and it's just caught me ever since, you know. And I started kind of developing my skills as a songwriter maybe kind of halfway through secondary school, and ever since then I've just been developing my skills and listening to music all through my life. And my mum and my dad listening to music just became a thing that I couldn't let go of, and even though I had interest elsewhere, it just always kind of seemed like that was what I wanted to do. It started becoming a thing that it could be a career path, but I would have to like start early and go for it. And I did start a band, November Lights, and it was great. You know, it felt like you're in a dream scenario at that point. You know, like being in a band was always this kind of fantasy, and then it started developing a bit, and then we really got somewhere with it. And I think that's when I realised that this could be something I could do, you know, whether it was within the band or just as a musician. When Talk came out, it just came out like any other song for us, and that was it. And it always went down well live, and you know, it was probably, well, I'm speaking for myself, it was definitely one of my favourite songs to play live, and it always seemed to connect. And then, you know, I literally woke up one morning and it had hundreds of thousands of views on YouTube, and I guess that had never happened before. And I think even at that point, you know, everyone was just like, the band, as much as it was trying to be a career, at that point it was kind of a hobby as well. And to see that, and then eventually to now it, you know, passing 5 million views on YouTube, which is just crazy. And you know, and then after that did kind of take off, we then had a DJ come in overseas, and he remixed it, and even that blew up on Spotify, and that's got millions of streams as well. And I'd never seen a song grow that much. And I suppose when I look back on it, I kind of see it as a lifeline for me, that song, because as much as the band stopped going, that song kept going. And that was the crazy thing. And you know, as soon as someone came in and remixed it, you know, they released that song under a label. And now, ever since then, I've been working with that label and working with that DJ in particular and other DJs and producers. As soon as the band came to an end and I did have a career path, you know, as a songwriter, I wanted to make sure that, as much as I like working on different genres of music that I was never used to, I wanted to make sure that the music that I really loved writing, I was still able to do, and I was still able to find a way of that getting out there. So I started working with a lot of artists, solo artists around Scotland that were doing their own thing and wanted to collaborate. And it was like doing sessions in this room with people and just working on their artist projects and trying to, you know, not so much help them, but just trying to see what they wanted to do and what they wanted to achieve with the artist project, and just for me to just hopefully be, I suppose, a helping hand or just a small part of it. Everyone seems to ask the question of, is it music first or is it lyrics, you know, but it's never really that for me. You know, if something comes into my head, even if I'm not even in this room with an instrument, I'm just straight on my phone recording my voicemail. It's just so I've got it there. Maybe that'll give me something to build on the next day. So I'm really lucky that I'm working with a new writing partner, Honey Hopkins. She's a new addition. That's plenty. She's been, you know, a saving grace for the last 3 or 4 months. And you know, she's quite talented. She plays a bit of piano. But I think that's, when she sees someone up at the window, she just jumps up, plays a bit of the piano. She's going to get better with time. She's only 5 months. Stop that. But she's been great. And this is usually where she sits. If I'm ever walking at the computer, she usually sits right here.
My face looks like a Monday. A shiver is a smile. Haven't seen you in a while. I'm shaking with anxiety. I know it's only butterflies, but something seemed to change my mind. I've never seen the type of look in someone's face. Something told me I was just one of your outtakes.